out of 7 crore entrepreneurs, MSMEs, 30% are almost dead.
Their own minister, Nitin Gadkari, he's been writing letters to the Prime Minister. So far, no action has been taken.
Very, very unfortunate that the government, instead of punishing the perpetrators, they are protecting them.
You are the only voice for us.
It is always an honor and a pleasure for me to come to this wonderful stage.
Thank you for coming here for this discussion. I think small and medium industry is the backbone of job creation. If you ask most people, they talk to you about large companies, about the sort of commanding heights, but the people who actually do the homework and the people who actually get the jobs are the small and medium industries. And that's why I wanted to come and have a conversation about yourselves, about what you're thinking, and potentially what the future in Tamil Nadu can be.
I'll just read out one thing. JSW Steel reported a jump of over 1,300% in its consolidated net profit to 2,669 crore for the December 2020 quarter. So only the corporates are making money and we are left in the lurch. Nobody has addressed this issue. So many representations have gone from here to the government through various sources. But nobody has addressed this finally. And their own minister, Nitin Gadkari, he's been writing letters to the Prime Minister. But so far, no action has been taken on it. That's what he was meaning.
I can also help you and try and raise it for you if you want.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. In spite of large number of educational institutions in Coimbatore and in the country, still lack of employability skills. How do you think we can change that?
The first thing that we need to do is we need to start the economy once again. And we need to start the economic engine, which is jammed. There is no linkage between our education system and the business system and the industrial system. So we should link the education system to the industrial system, to the business system. Without that linkage, we will always be training people who will be useless for you. So we have to bring that into the education system.
Good afternoon, Rahulji. Like you have come from Delhi, I have come from Chennai for you.
Thank you.
I am not a single person talking to you. I am representing consortium of Indian associations, which is over 350,000 industries. What are we witnessing? I have been a 3.5 decade entrepreneur. What are we witnessing today in this country? We moved from Skill India, Digital India, Make in India, Atmanirbhar, and finally ended where? Fund India. What is Fund India? FDA. We are opening, asking others to give money to us. Where are we? I am sick to see the entrepreneurs surviving. Out of 7 crore entrepreneurs, MSMEs, 30% are almost dead.
Yeah.
What is 30%? 2.1 crore. That 2.1 crore gives jobs for almost 20 crore of people. We are not bothered. The ECGLS scheme came for 45 lakhs beneficiary out of 7.5 crores. Where are we? We are seeing only the balance 60% and saying green shoots. I am seeing shooting myself as an entrepreneur. How are we progressing? What answer will I give to my children? Today, entrepreneur, you ask them, we are facing 3 M problems. Money, manpower, material. Banks are chasing, NBFCs are chasing. We are not able to open a newspaper today. Every page has got only about auction sale notice, possession notice. Big people are getting shaved. We are being shaved. You are the only voice for us. Don't forget it. Micro industries, 98% in this country. 98% is the micro industries. Micro industries must have a separate ministry. We cannot be combined with 100 crore company turnover. I am talking micro as a self-employed people. We are losing them. Today the dream of a startup is shattered. Today we have seen we are not able to raise our voice. We are not able to express ourselves. We are not being heard. We are not being able to convey our pains. An entrepreneur can never ever cry openly. Remember that. If I cry openly, nobody will trust me. Nobody will give me business. No employee will stay with me. I don't hire people with just money. I hire people from my heart and love. I build this nation. I have built this nation for 35 years. Today I see wherever I go. I'm telling you, Mr. Rahul, I'm representing Consortium of Indian Association. People are painfully crying. Please raise it. Please speak for us. Thank you for coming to Coimbatore. Thank you for hearing me out. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Please do feel free to come to me. I can raise things even if I'm in opposition. And I will help you whether I'm in opposition or in government. But I believe that you are central to this country and the success of this country. Thank you very much.